There's wanami is also the widely cultured shrimp in the world, and China produces more than half of the white shrimp in the world.
Yeah.
The production of wanami is increasing from 1.4 million tons to 1.8 million tons in the last 8 years. And we can see that the production of the shrimp reared in the freshwater keeps consistent in the last 8 years. So the production increase mainly contributed by the shrimp farmed in the seawater. And the production of Pinellas monodon is around 80,000 tons in the last 8 years. But in this year, they said the production may be doubled. And for other two kinds of Pinellas, Pinellas japonicus and funeral Pinellas chinensis, their production is around 40,000 tons and keep consistent in the last 8 years.
Head Doctor, please change your slide.
Oh. So.
Yes, now you can go ahead.
Actually, I changed my slide, so I will try again. Can you see the changes?
Yes, now we can provide.
Okay. As we know, fish meal is the most important ingredient in the feed of shrimp. And compared with other ingredients, especially compared to plant proteins, fish meal has some advantage, such as it has relatively high protein. Usually the protein content is more than 60%, and it usually have more balanced amino acids, especially for the limited amino acids. And it usually has low content of anti-nutritional factors and high content of micronutrients, such as some vitamin and some minerals. And it also has some high content of HEFAs, such as DHA and EPA. And also, the fish meal has a really high digestibility of most of the nutrients. And in our research, they estimated the global use of fish meal within compound aquafeed. We can see from the picture that shrimp feed used about 27% fish meal, which is the most in the aquatic animals. And actually, fish meal replacement is widely studied in shrimp. Traditionally, the fish meal will be replaced by other ingredients and usually will be supplemented with some limited amino acids, such as lysine. And from a more practical standpoint, blend protein source would be better. And from the point of economic and production, a blend protein usually be the best choice. And in the last 10 years, I have done a series of research to reduce the fish meal content in shrimp feed. Firstly, I evaluated the function of some non-essential amino acids in the low fish meal diet, such as the glycine, the proline, and the GBA. I found their special role in the low fish meal diet. And then we try to explore the comprehensive strategy for the fish meal replacement in the shrimp feed. Firstly, we try to balance the amino acids, not only the limited amino acids, but also the functional amino acids.
Hello,
and
Dr.
Also,
Wilson. Sorry to disturb you. Actually, slides are not changing.
Okay.
We are still in slide six.
Okay, so can you present for me? I'm not sure. Can you present for me the PPT?
If you have no problem, then we can present your talk from our side.
Yeah.
Hello.
Hello. So can you play the PowerPoint for me?
I'm audible. Please wait for 2 minutes. We will share your slide from our side.
So I'm not sure. For this, you can see the changes of the slide.
Yes. Now it's visible.
Yes.
Now.
So maybe this is enough. Yeah.
Okay. No problem. You can go ahead.
Yeah, if it's okay, continue.
Okay.
Yeah, so we explored some comprehensive traits, and we try to balance the amino acids, and we try to add some minerals and vitamins, and we add some enemies such as fetus to improve the digestibility of the shrimp. But after we done, and it is still hard to reduce the fish meal to below 15%. So what's the problem exactly now? I think the first problem is always being neglected. Although we added fish oil in the low fish meal diet, lipid metabolism was still being suppressed in shrimp feed the low fish meal diet. In our previous research, we could find that the cholesterol, glucose, TG, and the bile acids all decreased with the decreasing dietary fish meal levels, and some lipid metabolism related gene expression were also affected by dietary fish meal or levels. And for other problem, maybe the immune response. We have done a lot of parameters. For example, we have done some ER stress related gene expression, and we also done some histology changes. We could find that the low fish meal diet impaired the health of shrimp. So do we have our feed additive could improve the lipid metabolism and the immune response of shrimp? I think the bile acids may be a good choice, because bile acids, as we know, it plays an important role in the digestion and the absorption, especially for the lipid digestion. So it could improve the lipid metabolism of the shrimp, and the bile acids also serves as a critical signal molecule in regulating immune response, and it is also a major regulator of the gut microbiota. So we think bile acids also can improve the immune response of the shrimp. Actually, in the last year, some researchers have reviewed the bile acids metabolism in fish, and they found that dietary fish meal alternatives often disturb bile acid status in fish, resulting in either increased excretion or decreased intestinal reabsorption, and decreased the bile acid synthesis. And this situation may be mitigated by the processing of fish meal alternatives, as well as the dietary inclusion of some bile acids. And although the bile acids is traditionally regarded as anthracite incrustation. And now a few recent studies have revealed the critical role of bile acids in the diet of shrimp, especially this article published in Aquaculture Nutrition. It's published in this year. The authors have found the special role of bile acids on the growth performance, lipid metabolism, non-specific immunity, and intestinal microbiota of wet shrimp. And in this study, we used the CDC or primary bile acids, which widely used in human and animal studies. And we want to evaluate whether bile acids could alleviate the negative effects brought by low fish meal diet. So then I will present my first experiment. Dietary supplementation of CDC improved the growth performance, immune response, and the intestinal health of juvenile pineus monodon feed a low fish meal diet. In this experiment, three delta was formulated. A high fish meal delta with 25% fish meal and a low fish meal delta with about 15% fish meal, and the fish meal is replaced by the soy protein concentrate. And also a low fish meal delta supplemented with 0.1% of CDCA. And in the low fish meal diet, some amino acids and minerals and vitamins were added in the low fish meal diet. And in this study, the shrimp used is about 0.3 gram, and there are about 30 shrimp in one tank, and each diet was sent to four replicates. And the experiment is lasted for about 8 weeks. And first, we can see the growth performance. The shrimp feed the low fish meal diet. They are thin body weight, weight gain, and feed efficiency are all lower than those in high fish meal group. And the low fish meal diet supplemented with CDC showed no difference with other two groups. It could say that the CDC partially improved the growth performance of shrimp. And we also measured the lipid metabolism related gene expression. And we can say that the dietary supplementation of CDC also improved the lipid metabolism of the shrimp. And we also detected the gene expression of immune response in hepatopancreas. We can see that the expression of SOD, CAT, and radish, their expression all enhanced by the supplementation of CDCA. And similar results were found in the immune response in the intestine. Also, we can see that SOD and CAT, XBP1, and the radish, their expression are affected by the dietary supplementation of CDCA. We also measure the histology of the intestine and hepatopancreas. We can see that the intestinal fold height was lower in low fish meal group, and we can also say that the ER swollen was found in the low fish meal group. So could you see the slide change? Could you see that? Sorry, could you see the changes of slides?
Yes, Yes, we can
yes.
see.
Yes. Oh, okay. Oh, okay. No problem. And we can see that the dietary supplementation of CDCA they improve the intestinal health of the shrimp. And we also measured the intestinal microbiota of the Pinaris monodon. And we can see that the diversity and the richness of the intestinal microbiota was decreased in the low fish meal group. And the dietary supplementation of CTC elevated this situation. And further analysis showed that there are clear differences in intestinal microbiota of the shrimp feed the different diets. And in this figure is the significant feature of phylum. So we can see that the proteobacteria was lower in the group of supplemented with CDCA. And here is the significant feature of top 50 general. Dietary supplementation of CDCA could decrease the harmful bacteria abundance, especially the Weber. And we have done some further analysis of the intestinal microbiota. And from this figure, we can see that the Weber and the proteobacteria was also enriched in the low fish meal group. And the conclusion for this experiment, the first will be low dietary fish meal decrease the weight gain, impaired the immune ability, induced intestinal damage, and disturbed intestinal microbiota of Pinaris monodon. Dietary supplementation of 0.1% CDCA in the low fish meal diet enhanced the antioxidative ability, elevated the ER stress, improved the microbiota diversity, and decreased the harmful bacteria abundance of Pinaris monodon. And then I will show the second experiment. This experiment is a dietary supplementation of CDCA on little Pinaris vaname. Feed the diet with fish meal replaced by Clostridium oxygenum protein. And this protein is a kind of bacterial protein which can produce the alcohol. And for this kind of protein, it has really high protein content with about 85% and extremely low lipid content. And in this experiment, five diets were formulated. Also a high fish meal diet, a low fish meal diet, and three diets with different dosage of CDCA. And actually this experiment is just finished in the early of this month. So until now, we only have the data of growth performance. And from this table, we can see that dietary supplementation of 300 and 600 milligram CDCA partially improved the growth of shrimp. They have no difference with the high fish meal group. And what we are working on now, we are doing the transcriptomics change induced by low fish meal and the CDCA. And we also done the intestinal microbiota changes induced by low fish meal and the CDCA. And we also detected the intestinal health. And what we are, what's our future plan? We just started a new experiment with Shandong Longchang, and we want to evaluate the commercial bio assays products in the shrimp, and we also want to compare the difference between the commercial bio assays and the pure bio assays such as CDCA and the UDCA. And we also want to study the interactions between dietary lipids and bile acids. And maybe we can share our future result in the next meeting. And thanks for your attention. Thanks, everyone.